making his way to the cage tonight in our 10th fight of the night, Josh Neal out of Milicic Fighting Systems in East Moline, Illinois, with a record of 2-1.
Mr. Neal is somebody who we're pretty familiar with. We've seen him fight several times. Definitely one of those guys that's pretty good standing up, pretty good on the ground. He's going to come with tons of energy. I know he's been working really hard with MFS. You know, when you have that MFS tag on you, it's definitely something that you can be proud of, and you're definitely going to represent that once you get into the cage.
I'm really excited to see this fight because he's coming off a controversial decision in some people's eyes. It's one of those, like, he's coming off of a loss, right, which he thought he won, which, you know, a percentage of the people that night thought he won. The other half were for obviously for Stewart. And whenever you've got that, he's going to want to make a statement tonight.
Right. And you know he has that hunger. After you got a loss where, you know, you feel like you won, you feel like you've been wrong, you know that he's going to come into this octagon tonight ready to throw his hands, ready to get a definitive win over his opponent.
And then we're talking to even that night and a little bit after that, he's like, all I can do is go back and train and come out my next fight and you know, and get that win. And so here we are again. There was not a lot of time in between time.
No.
So big credit for him for taking the fight so soon. And we'll see what he does. Making his way to the cage tonight, Joseph Dean Walter out of Knoxville, Illinois, and Central Illinois Combat Club with a record of 4-3.
What do you think we can expect out of Walter tonight, especially facing an opponent like Neal, who's, you know, obviously has that hunger going on right now?
If he did his homework, like I hope that he did against Neal, he's going to know that Neal has the huge power takedowns. So stay out of the way. Keep your distance. 1-2, 1-2, get in, get out. Stay away from the takedowns. Neal's obviously the bigger of the two guys. So we're going to see. He's just got to get out of the way of that. Central Illinois Combat Club, Bob Long, like we've talked about.
Yeah.
Stellar club, stellar team. And, you know, they're both in phenomenal shape. And this is one of those flip 'em fights for me, man.
Yeah, and we know that you know, coming out of Central Illinois Combat Club, that Bob Long has taught him exactly what he needs to do. He's going to know exactly what his game plan should be, how he can beat Neal. Now, the problem is when you have to go into that octagon and execute that.
Such a lifesaver, man.
Oh.
This is going to be a really action-packed fight. You can tell both of these guys are ready.
I like the head movement already by Neil.
Yeah.
There's that front kick to kind of keep him his distance a little bit. Nice kick coming through. Walter just waiting. Just kind of waiting to counter. Nice combo
nice kick
there,
by
too.
Walter, yeah.
There's a
Nail
big
taking it to him.
Big shots to set up a takedown.
Huge takedown right there by him.
We knew that was coming, and so should have Walter. I like how he set it up with about three or four shots to get in there and then just gets a huge takedown. Now, here's where the last fight, Neil, was kind of talked about for sometimes doing enough, sometimes not. So I want to think that he's going to stay more active right now on the ground.
Right, yeah. If there was anything that you could say after that last fight was that he wasn't quite busy enough when he was on top and on the ground. So let's see if he's able to do that. Walter's doing a great job of keeping Neil's head tucked right into his chest.
Right.
It's kind of hard to swing when you don't know exactly what you're swinging at.
If you can't posture up, you can't get any leverage coming down. So you just have these little shots that don't really do a whole lot of damage. You know, it's frustrating to the fighter, too. You can see Neil trying to pop up. And
I really like how Walter's, you know, doing some offense from the bottom. You know, a lot of times you don't see that. You see those guys sort of trying to posture and trying to you know, maybe flip their opponent over. But Walter's taking advantage of that and trying to do some damage from the bottom. Both guys throwing and being active. And this is something you don't really see all the time. You know, you get this, you know, it might be considered a rest position, you know, for some of these guys. And, you know, as you can see, our referee isn't standing them up because both these guys are being really active.
Here we go back on our feet. I got to say, once again, this is 160 pounders. They're very big for 160 pounds. Strong 160ers. So big body
really
shot.
Really nice body shot right there by Neil.
I like how Neil seems to be opening up a little bit more, too, in this fight. You know, and like I said, he got a lot of criticism last time for doing the takedowns and staying, so he's trying to mix it up a little bit.
Right, and both of these guys should be really good at range. You know, they have long limbs. They should be able to take advantage of that with both of themselves.
Big front kick in, too. I've got to think that Neil's going to go into another, you know, 3-4 hit combo and get ready for the takedown. See right there, Neil looking at his legs, kind of deciding if he wants to do that or not. And Walter doing a great job of keeping him away. Neil tries to go high, and here's where the last 10 seconds. Is somebody going to put it on and put a stamp on the round? Walter does that. Both fighters.
Real nice left jab there
Neil
by Neil.
Lands that.
Really impressed with Walter that round, too. You know, it's kind of tough when you have somebody who's, you know, sort of trying to be that aggressor, and you're able to counter that. And Walter did a really good job of doing that.
These guys both, Neil, too, a couple fights away from title contention potentially in March, maybe in the end of the year. So this fight's really important for these guys. Gets caught there, does Neil.
Neil continues to sort of paw those jabs out there, which is good to stay busy, but you got to be careful that you don't get countered.
And those counter fighters are hard to fight against, too, and Walter is definitely one of those fighters, just waiting for something from Neil. And there goes Neil again. And this time, before Neil's able to shoot and get a takedown, Walter drops down and stops it.
Nice knee there by Walter at the very end to get that separation.
Ooh, right up the pipe.
Really nice shot right there by Neil.
I like those up jabs when they do that. It's kind of those hybrid uppercut and jab. It's nice. I like how Neil's also fighting long. He's really stretching out to try to get.
Yeah, use that size. Use that length that you have.
And Walter's doing a great job, just being very patient, not being reckless. There goes Neil in with another flurry. And Walter just very calm and collect, just waiting for the right moment, doing a great job countering.
Yep, doesn't look agitated in there, doesn't look like he's seeing something that he hasn't seen before.
Right,
so
now Walter's wanting to get the underhooks and turn Neil around in the cage. But Neil is able to break free, and we've got him right back in the middle of the cage. Stiff
nice shot there by Walter. Real
big
nice shot.
Right there, yes.
Nice shot there by Neil.
Both fighters are really getting in on each other. I like how Neil went low there and tried to come back up the top. I had to think that Walter's corner is wanting him to start pushing the pace a little bit more and maybe not counterfight as much to kind of finish the round off that way.
And this is one of those fights where you definitely see the talent, you know, coming out. And both of these guys are really skilled in the cage.
Neil just going for that big bomb. Body shot again.
Yeah, Walter probably should try to let his hands fly a little bit more.
Inside kick, right. I've got to think that if it gets to the third round, his corner tells him that. Got to be coming upon the end of the round and pretty close here. And so this is what I think at the end of this we're going to... Ooh, big shot from Walter. Neil opens up a few shots of his own. Good flurry right there. 10 seconds, let loose. Oh, landed another body shot there and came in with the top. So Neil's really getting in some unorthodox punches.
Yeah, really nice knee there at the very tail end by Walter, too. Yeah, entertaining fight, man. Entertaining fight so far.
I will give that round slightly to Neil. Did land a few more shots, a few more power shots than Walter did. But I think real close again.
Yeah, if there's one thing that I would say with Walter right now, when he's landing, he's landing. You know, he has a very nice strategy.
I could see really both fighters coming out very strong in this first minute of this third round and seeing what each other's got. So here we go on the third round between Joseph Dean Walter and Josh Neal.
Both fighters definitely turning it up going into this third round. Walter looking way more aggressive so far. Ooh, big shot there by Walter. Caught Neil coming in.
Yeah, but Neil automatically goes down for the takedown, which is smart. Looking for the double and single. Can't get it. Good sprawl and good knee from Walter as well.
Yes. I love that sprawl there from Walter when Neil was really trying to turn it on.
It came at the perfect time,
yes,
too, because
definitely.
He was going down. Good underhooks from Walter right there, looking to turn Neil right into the cage like he does right there. And now he can work from not having his back up against the
nice
cage.
Nice knee there by Walter as they separated from the exchange.
Very risky body shot there. Neil running away. It's real risky when you do that.
Yeah, you have to be really careful. Really nice body shot there by Neil.
Staying in the pocket. Wow, that's a telephone booth fighting right there.
Nice exchange by both fighters.
Low blow right there. Nope, that was a low blow. That looked like a low blow to me. And I understand that in the heat of the moment that it could have been close, but I mean, we're sitting here watching it, and we've got a different view from
it. It's so tough to you know, and you got to give credit to our to our referee right there to be able to see that and recognize that it was a low blow and not a KO. Because, you know, you could easily come in and stop that fight right there.
Yeah.
But he didn't. You know, that's really tough.
Here we go. Back in again.
Walter definitely still looking fatigued from that, you know, from that shot.
But it still digs deep to get that shot in, and Neil wanting to end it, and Walter still wanted, you know. You will find a way to win, regardless.
Oh, yeah. Oh, big shot there by O'Neal.
Good job of using that push kick to kind of separate himself a little bit. Nice leg kick from Walter. Body kick again from Walter.
Yep, and Neal caught him leaning in and caught him with that right. Another huge right there by O'Neal. Definitely be an aggressor as this round continues.
And Neil now looking, you know, I've got to think that he wants to finish this fight and really push the pace like he did, back up Walter against the cage, and then maybe that's what he's trying to set up with that push kick.
Right. Walter's gonna really have to sort of turn things up right now. Especially since, you know, and sort of, you know, try things like that, like that Superman punch, you know? That's smart to try right now.
there you go. You got to push the pace right there when he's got him backed up like that. That was Neil's time to turn it up a little bit.
Yeah, Neil is...
And I understand, you know, he's being very cautious too, but in the end of the round, right there, man, a big shot, and really got to capitalize on that. Keep going. You got to keep going.
Yeah, you got to let those hands fly at this point.
And there, right there. Don't get caught in the knees.
Big shot there by Neil.
And just keep going right now. Big body shots.
Win that round. Win that round right here, right now.
Nice knees from Walter too to finish the round out. Good finish from both fighters.
Yeah, good, very good finish. I really would have liked to see Walter turn it up like that, you know, maybe 30, 45 seconds before that. But Neil definitely did a great job of putting a lot of pressure on Walter at the very end.
And you can tell that he wanted to finish that fight. You know, his last fight, his decision, he didn't want that. He really wanted to finish it. Josh Neal improves his record to 3-1 over Joseph Dean Walter tonight here at Cage Aggression Challengers.